It's hard to believe that a brand new Toyota Camry with a few options and a V6 can easily cost you $35,000 or more when you look at all the amazing, terrible, old, depreciated, interesting cars that you could buy for the same amount of money. So for our latest installment of the What Would You Buy panel, I thought $35,000 would be an awesome budget. In fact, this was one of the budgets we considered really strongly as we were talking with Auto Tempest about what to do for Car Trek, because it is incredible what you can buy. I was going to try to buy a Ferrari 355 manual. I've seen several cars, especially Spiders with some top issues, that you can actually buy in the mid-30s. I actually was looking at a GTS that was in Hurricane Sandy, but had been well repaired. That would have been the perfect car for it, but I actually could never get in touch with the seller. That was the fair money for it, unquestionably, but he had listed it months ago and I didn't end up buying it. I also thought hard about a Maserati Gran Turismo MC Stradale. So the best version they ever made of the car, better aerodynamics, tons of carbon fiber. The Gran Turismo you can buy for 20 grand, but for not that much more, you can get a really cool, much later version that's a lot better car to own and much more sorted out than the early cars were. The other car that I was most excited about was a Ferrari 612 Scaglietti. Now you can't normally buy a 612 for that kind of money. You're gonna pay 60 to 90 grand from the worst to a decent car. But I found one that a scorned lover had vandalized with a high heel shoe. It was dinged and dented on every single panel. Several of the pieces of glass had been broken, and it seemed like it was a 25 to 30 grand car, even with some anticipated repairs. Now I was gonna try to PDR the dents out and, you know, buy some aftermarket glass and stuff and just put it back together for about 35 grand, but it was possible. All of those are terrible choices that would cost you a ton of money to maintain, but that's what I love. But I was curious what my friends would think, and these were their answers.
The car I would pick for 35,000. Already got it. Picked up this nice 1970 Chevelle. It's actually a Malibu, it's not a SS. This thing's got a 6-liter LS, ice cold modern air conditioning, overdrive transmission, billet wheels, disc brakes. You can't beat it. For 35 grand, you too can be riding in a resto-modded muscle car.
So, for a $35,000 budget, this week I would buy a Ford Focus RS. 350 horsepower, 11,000 kilometers, great chassis, blue nitrous. Everything is there. It's really a great car, matches the budget, and I could actually crack for real.
Well, you know, I ended up with a Turbo Camaro 1LE for 25, but I was looking with a guy named Hayes Harris at wirewheel.com. I ran him around on a couple of different cars before I finally decided on a Camaro instead. Hayes has right now on his website, this is my real answer. I'm not just a salesperson. He's got a 2012 Lotus Evora S stick shift, 34,000 miles, rebuilt title. All you gotta do is crack one of those clamshells and the cars are totaled. Fantastic, lightweight, sporty car, looks like a $200,000 exotic. I think they're really cool. I'd have bought this car if I didn't already have my Camaro. And if one of you don't beat me to it, I might see what Hayes will do me for a trade-in.
For me, this particular car comes down to 35K on occasion and immediately gets snatched up, and that is the Alfa Romeo 4C. What are you getting for the price of a 4Runner? You're getting a carbon fiber tub, turbo inline 4 that makes interesting Huayra noises, 0 to 60 in under 4 seconds, and if you behave, you'll get 34 miles to the gallon, or 8 if you're traveling by tow truck.
Hey everyone, PJ with Exotic Car Hacks, and today my favorite exotic car under $35,000 would have to be the Maserati Quattroporte GTS. Now you can buy a really nice spec 2009 all the way up to 2012 Maserati Quattroporte for under $35,000, and they are low mileage and in mint shape, so I cannot recommend it enough as one of the best starter exotic and also a very low maintenance exotic, if I can say that. But of course, like I always say, make sure you PPI well.
So you would say, I know what you're going to choose. Your Dr. M3, it's going to be a BMW E92 M3 like my buddy Tedward, or an F10 M5, the blue one that I had that I took delivery of in Munich, Germany, or the E64 V10 M6 that is the dream car that I have that I continue to own. But I'm going to tell you that you're wrong. For 35 grand, what you should get is not a car, but a truck. The Ford SVT Raptor. 6.2 liter V8, off-roading king to this day. Had so much fun in this truck off-road, doing donuts in the snow. 35 grand, how can you go wrong? SVT Raptor.
The car I choose is, of course, the Acura NSX. I think by far it is one of the best looking cars for a car that came out in 1990. Still today in 2020, people still think this car is ahead of its time.
Just at $35,000, brand new off the lot with a warranty, 460 horsepower, 420 foot-pounds of torque, 6-speed rev matching manual transmission comes as a no-cost standard option. Car show spectators everywhere will be terrified of you when you're leaving the show. Brand new Ford Mustang GT.
$35,000, what are you spending on? Sure, you can buy a Corvette, a Maserati, Ghibli, or any number of other cars, but for me, the choice is really easy. Nissan Skyline GTR R32, the car that was so good that it got banned from its class in racing. Car is all-wheel drive, manual transmission, 280 horsepower, twin turbo, it's light, it's flickable, it's fun, it's proven. There's a giant aftermarket for the car, parts, performance modifications, tires, wheels, brakes, body kits, and so forth and so on. You'd be really hard pressed to pick anything that could outdo that thing for that price. That would definitely be my pick, no question about it.
Now our budget this week is $35,000. You can pick up some amazing cars for that price point. If you follow along with some of my stories on VinWiki, you know I love Holden vehicles. We've got to do it for Australia. My daily driver, you can pick up for $35,000. That's a 2016 Jungle Green. It's an automatic 6.2 liter, 450 horsepower out of the box. We've got one of those. We have another one being worked on right, move my head up there, right there. That's a 2017. Those cars have come down easily with about 20,000 miles on it. You can pick them up for $35,000 all day long. Now these cars are LS powered, 6.2 liter. You have four whopping options with that. You can either get yourself a sunroof, a spare, your color, or whether you have a manual or automatic transmission. Now I've walked all the way up here to the front garage to prove that these cars are still available. We just picked up one last week, 5,100 miles. Woo! Still wearing its Chevrolet badges. Nightfall gray metallic. You can pick them up for $35,000.
For $35,000, I'm gonna frame this up as if I could only have one car. And as a guy with a family, a dog, a daughter, a wife, I'm gonna go with an SUV. I'm gonna go with a Porsche Cayenne GTS or a BMW X5M, both within just a few years old. You can find these things fully loaded. You can go do some spirited driving and you can lug the family around.
$35,000 is gonna get me one of the only two modern rear-wheel drive Hondas. It's gonna be the first generation Acura NSX. Absolutely love that car. It looks phenomenal. It still looks good today. It aged very well. It fits in with all the exotic and supercars of today's era. It sounds amazing with that V6 that pushes out 270 horsepower. And of course, it's got a 5-speed manual transmission. Absolutely phenomenal car. It's reliable, really fun to drive, and it'll turn heads everywhere you go.
I'm going to go with a 2009 Mercedes-Benz SL63 AMG. These cars were $140,000 new, still look really great today, so you'd be a big baller on a budget.
35K is a tough one. I think I have to go with a C6 Z06.
For $35,000, there are tons of Porsches that work really well, even 911s like the 997S or 993, but those cars aren't my style. I love GT cars better. So for 35K, I would actually go with a Corvette. I absolutely love the C6 Z06, one of my favorite cars, had to, tracked it a lot. But for that price point, you could also get a C7, which is a little more modern, has a nice dash and interior, and would be a lot better for daily street use, so that would be my choice.
So to avoid the pumpkin spice latte pick, C6 Z06 of the week that you've probably seen already twice in this video, I'm going all the way back to 1966, where I pick up a Peterbilt 351 Big Rig. Why a 1966 Peterbilt 351? Well, my friend Tavares turned me on to a great movie from 1971, Duel, where one of these trucks pulling an oil tanker was chasing a 71 Valiant through the desert, and was just a fantastic movie. I wouldn't be pulling an oil tanker around chasing old Valiants. I'd put a flat trailer to pull my cars around, because I think pulling up with a pair of Aston Martins from the previous week to a racetrack would be a great thing to do with a 1966 351 Peterbilt.
The car that I would buy is the 2017 Jaguar F-Type S Coupe with a manual. You can find these things on the internet all over the place. They're pretty rare. There wasn't a high take rate on them, but you can find them for right about that price with a few miles on them, still in great shape. I actually have an F-Type, and it's an automatic, which I sort of inherited from my mother. Eventually, I may have to give it back to her. I've been using it as a daily. It's a lovely car. It's got plenty of power, great balance, and in the manual version, the Getrag 6-speed gearbox that they use in that car is straight out of the BMW M4. So if you like the shifter feel and pedal feel of the manuals in the BMWs, well, you will like the feel of the manual in the Jaguar.
I'd probably pick me up a really nice 87 Buick Grand National that's been modified with about 500 or 600 horsepower. You can get them on the forums for around $35,000. If I had to pick a second car, I'm definitely going to pick a C5 Z06 manual that's also been modified. There's a couple Instagram pages and Facebook pages where these cars are always for sale that are pro-charged, supercharged, or turbocharged. And they're usually in that $35,000 range for a nice 700 or 800 horsepower modern car. And that's what I would pick if I had to pick a car for $35,000.
You know, it's amazing to me that you have choice of these two entry-level supercars for $35,000. So you have the legendary Porsche 911 Turbo, this one being a 996 Turbo with higher mileage, 70 or 80,000 miles or so, or you have the best looking car on the road, an 06 to 08 Aston Martin V8 Vantage. So do you want about 500 horsepower with an easy tune, or more of a GT and you feel like James Bond? For me, I have to go with the Aston. It is absolutely drop dead gorgeous. It sounds incredible. It's got a great shifting 6-speed manual and truly is an event to drive. So I take mine with coarse deviated stitching and the Sport Pack.
For $35,000, I'd be buying a 1969 RS SS Camaro. Now, while I prefer the 427 or the 396, it need not be numbers matching, as I would probably drive around for a little bit and then LS swap it with a T56 and make it worth a lot more than $35,000.
Two cars I'd like to own at that number. One is an Alfa Romeo GTA. I always thought that that little car has great styling. I know it's got great handling, despite the fact that I've never driven one, but I've always had a little place in my heart for that car. And the other one for $35,000, I'd be looking at an Aston Martin V8 Vantage from the 07-09 vintage. I think at $35,000, you get a lot of car for your money there. Yeah, they might be expensive to maintain, but beautiful looking car. Makes all the right noises, and you can get it into 6-speed.
Well, you know what I'm gonna say? For around $35,000, you can find a good DeLorean. The prices keep going up on these things. They're going up to $40,000, $50,000, but you can still find them for around $35,000 if you're willing to put a little time and effort into them. The design is timeless. Everybody loves Back to the Future. Everybody loves the DeLorean. It's a great car, and even Casey will tell you can daily drive these things.
2007 Aston Martin V8 Vantage. I found a beautiful silver one on red leather, manual, 29,000 miles. For $35,000, this is the car for me.
My pick at $35,000 is a 380 horsepower, all-wheel drive wagon. That's right, the 2018 Jaguar XF Sportbrake. Tough to find below a $40,000 price point, but with some haggling, you're going to land right on the money at $35,000.
My choice is the 2007 Aston Martin V8 Vantage. The car that I found was lightning silver, black leather interior, 6-speed manual gearbox, and just a great car for the money. Not a lot for maintenance, and very fun to drive, especially when you have that tachometer up.
If you want to go racer boy, over 444 horsepower, twin turbo V6, it's got everything you need to go really fast. You got the 2017 M3. Now this car is priced perfectly, still in warranty, right around $35,000 to $38,000. There's no other car in that price point that has as much as this car if you really want performance-driven focus. Now, if you don't want to go super fast all the time, if you're not living on a track, then we have the 2016 BMW 650 M Sport package. Why not the M6? Because you can get the M Sport package with so many less miles, already in warranty. You can do a few mods to it, still be just as fast in a straight line as the M3, and you get four doors. Four doors with no pillars. Now, this is my car. I just bought this car. I know that it costs $35,000 because I am in it less than $35,000. You can't do that. Look at this interior. You can't get any of these features for less than 35 grand. Nowhere. So, BMW. That's what I'm going to pick. That's my 35 grand.
The $35,000 mark is perfect because that translates to about $48,000 Canadian, which happens to be exactly what I spent on my wife's car 4 days ago. So what did we get? We ended up with a Porsche Macan S. It's a 2017. It's got the nice big RS wheels. It's fully loaded, all that great stuff. And it's got 340 horsepower stock. I'm going to throw one of those Cobb Stage 2 on there and hopefully get up to a lot more.
35 grand is a really tough choice for me. I really like the Viper GTS Coupe. It has a lot of nostalgia for me, and it has great styling that harkens back to the Shelby Daytona Coupe. It has a truck V10 that produces 450 horsepower. They're all made in manual, and it sort of has air conditioning. However, the 90s Chrysler interior just kills it for me. So my choice is the Aston Martin DB7 Vantage. It has a V12 engine, 420 horsepower, classic British styling that is one of the greatest, most beautiful shapes ever penned, and a Tremec T56 six-speed manual shared with a Corvette. So of course, how could I not love it?
I think for the money, you gotta get a 911. Manual 911, a 997, that's just gonna be the best go-to car all around. You can daily it, reliability, and everything.
Hey guys, so there's a bunch you could do with $35,000. You could go the depreciated exotics route. You could look into a Maserati Gran Turismo or a Aston Martin V8 Vantage, or you could look at a 997 Porsche Carrera S coupe. If you find one of these in a stick, decent miles, these are a hoot. This is the only car that I've never gotten bored of just because of how different it is and how unique it is in its own ways. It's not the fastest thing on the road, but it's certainly one of the most engaging. And for that reason only, it would be my pick for 35K.
All right, guys, for $35,000, I've got two basic choices. The first one is actually not a car. I would wait and find a Bimota Tessi 3D motorcycle. That's a beautiful Italian motorcycle. It's got the 1100cc Ducati engine and no front fork. It actually has a swing arm. It's a gorgeous work of art in the red and white with the gold wheels. Now, my car selection is simple. Finally, Ferrari prices are coming a little bit back to reality, so I'd either find a fixer-upper 308, or if I could find a 308 GT4, or even maybe, I think this is because I'm getting old and tired of seeing the Magnum PI 308s, I'd get a hardtop Mondial.
If I had $35,000 to spend, I'd probably overhaul my XJ6, but if I had to buy a car, I'd probably choose a 1991 or a 1992 Lancia Delta HF Integrale. I'd see if my budget would stretch to an Evo 1. I've seen them in this country going for about £27,000, £28,000. So with the exchange rate, I think it would come in under budget. You've got a 2-litre engine. It's turbocharged, all-wheel drive. You've got back seats and enough boot space for all your shopping. And on an evening like this, on these Welsh roads, I can't think of anything better than being behind the wheel of that Lancia.
The coolest $35,000 car I think you can buy would be a 997 generation 911 Carrera S in a manual transmission. And for 35 grand, you could get one with reasonable miles, either that has the IMS already done, or you could get it done.
Thank you guys, great answers as always. If you enjoyed that, please subscribe for more. And if you've got a better idea or something that we forgot about, please let us know in the comments. We've really enjoyed seeing all of your awesome ideas and thoughts throughout the time that we've been making these videos. So we'll make some more at a different price point next week, but thank you guys so much for watching. We want to thank Exotic Car Hacks for sponsoring this video and this month of VinWiki Car Stories. Exotic Car Hacks offers an educational resource that's the compiled knowledge of many industry experts to make it easier than ever for you to buy, own, and sell your dream car. They help you to minimize cost by helping you to buy it right, treat things as an asset, leverage financing, and use their ownership and enthusiast user base to help you make the best decision possible. They offer some great insights into what are the best cars to buy right now, and even some examples that you could go out and start negotiating on. So be sure to check out the link in the description below for a discount, the best deals, in fact, they've offered since Black Friday, and you'll be well on your way to your first exotic car hack.